Since the death of George Floyd, Susan Elizabeth Littlefield shows us how some black-owned businesses are getting a big boost.
For many business owners, 2020 has caused sheer panic.
When COVID first hit, I was like, what's going to happen with my nonprofit?
Kiana Cook runs a sewing nonprofit for kids and designs clothing and jewelry in the North Loop. After COVID started, she pivoted to mask making. After George Floyd was killed, she pivoted to making Black Lives Matter inspired earrings. And business is on a major upswing.
We actually need to be funded so that we can thrive and bring more communities into our community so we can change the narrative, write the narrative together.
And it's much the same here at Soul Bowl in the North Loop.
Since the protests and the George Floyd case, we've definitely had a huge uptick in business from new customer people that haven't had Soul Bowl before.
In fact, the busiest day of business Soul Bowl has ever seen was this past Juneteenth. And they've been passing on the recent good fortune.
We've been doing food drives and donations, making food for people who had their businesses burned down.
The issue, or if you want to call it that, is like, how long does this last? Like, is this a trend? Just because it's trending right now, is this something that's going to happen, or is this going to be sustainable?
The owners say the money has been nice, but it's the newfound relationships that are invaluable and hopefully sustaining.
Well, we want people to keep coming, like the food, and just let us grow.
In Minneapolis, Susan Elizabeth Littlefield, WCCO 4 News.
Earlier today, Netflix announced it will invest $100 million in black-owned banks in an effort to help close the wealth gap between blacks and white Americans.